Hello, everyone. Don't forget to get your dose of inspiration. Go to inspiredjourneyconsulting.com/book and get your copy of The Ultimate Guide to Creating Your Soul-Aligned Business. What do you think of when you hear the word sustainable? It's a phrase tossed around quite frequently these days. But have you ever experienced a resort that implemented sustainable practices in everything they do, including hiring? Carlos Gonzalez, co-founder and executive director, shares how this vision came to life at Las Qolqas Eco Resort. He tells us about their intentional hiring practices, favoring the groups that have the least chance to be employed in Peru, how it is a priority for their team to receive love in new ways by expressing their talents. While most employees have had lives filled with hard work and dedication, the gratitude from a guest or team member can bring to light just how special their gifts are. When visiting Las Qolqas, spend morning meditation in the BioGeoDome, where the glass wall faces east, to paint your experience in the warm colors of the sunrise. Or try an exfoliating spa treatment with seasonal ingredients. The milky white corn will be used during rainy season. If you visit during dry season, the harvested quinoa will be part of the scrub. Walk the garden with the resident farmer Santiago, or learn from Charlie how to make a pisco punch. This is your haven in Ollantaytambo for exploration and self-discovery. Thank you for listening today and always. If you haven't already done so, please rate the podcast on Apple, Spotify, or wherever you listen. It's a simple way to support me and increases the likelihood of others finding through Inspired Eyes. Enjoy the episode, and remember, travel can heal. You're listening to Through Inspired Eyes. Hi, I'm Jackie Roby, CEO of Inspired Journey Consulting, and your host today and always. I'm an international speaker, co-author of a best-selling book, and a solopreneur. Travel, mental wellness, diversity, and inclusion are the foundation of my life, my business, and this podcast. Celebrating our uniqueness is everything. Whether consulting on sales and marketing, curating training, or through private coaching, I help immersive wellness resorts sparkle. The travel industry has my heart. You spend your lives caring for others, but are you caring for yourself? By weaving in human design and mental wellness practices, I support hoteliers and travel designers to shine in their brilliance. In each episode, you'll be able to hear from guests that can support your wellness and healing journey. Through Inspired Eyes focuses on all aspects of wellness, embraces healing, and takes a deep dive into the travel industry. Parts of it that most of us overlook. Listen your way into better travel and a better you. Welcome to Through Inspired Eyes. Today we are traveling to Cusco. We're going to explore beautiful parts of nature. We're going to see what life is like in an eco-friendly resort. Welcome today, our special guest, Carlos Gonzalez, the co-founder and executive director of Las Qolqas Eco Resort. Welcome, Carlos.
Hello, Jackie. How are you?
Wonderful. I'm so grateful to have you here.
Thank you for the opportunity to share our vision with your listeners.
Absolutely. So tell us first, what inspired Las Qolqas?
Well, Herman Van den Balbaque is an entrepreneur and a former financial banker who purchased a piece of land in a beautiful setting near the village of Ollantaytambo in the Sacred Valley of the Incas almost 8 years ago because he was planning to retire and set up camp there for himself and for his family. But suddenly he realized that that wouldn't be feasible in the midterm because his children are still in school, He has a very busy schedule living in Europe. He's still often in finance and investment in Europe. So he still wanted to do something there in Ollantaytambo. He's always been a very sensible person about the environment and our culture because his mother is Peruvian. His father is from the Netherlands and his mother is Peruvian. So that's when he contacted me and he asked me if I would be interested in developing something different and something to pay homage to the nature and the culture of the Sacred Valley for future generations. And that's how we became partners in this adventure called Las Qolqas.
It's amazing. Now, one thing that I know you mentioned is, speaking of setting something up for the future, there's a lot of honoring to what's local and indigenous to the area. And mm-hmm. you've done work in terms of some of the plant life, correct?
Yes, yes. So when Herman told me about his idea, I told him that I of course was interested in doing something unique, something related to nature, to protect the environment and the cultural patrimony, because when you step outside of Las Qolqas, you just get across from our property, you're already on an Inca trail that takes you to several archaeological sites that we are aimed to protect as we speak today. But I also told him that my approach to sustainability was on a 360 degrees basis. I really wanted our project to be part of the community, not just some foreign people coming in to develop something nice for foreign travelers, but to really blend in with the community, with the surroundings. And we are very proud to have partnered with several of our neighbors who develop experiences for our guests. We have Porfi, for example, who is a tour operator who lives in a native community nearby. He's an ultra-marathonist who has run several 200K marathons cross-country, and he's also a farmer. And he leads the trips and experiences that we offer at Las Qolqas. We also have Minu, who is a therapist who does dance and movement therapies at the hotel at our newly released bio, Geodome. We really wanted to be part of the community. We really wanted to share the benefits of tourism with our neighbors in Ollantaytambo. All our team is owned by people from the Cusco region, and 80% of our workers are from Ollantaytambo itself. Many of them live just a few steps away from the property. All our products are local as well. We only offer both at our restaurant and at our spa. We offer experiences that are basically based on local, organic, seasonal products. So to us, that is really to be part of our community.
That's really special. I love the thoughtfulness in every step. So when you're using seasonal ingredients in the spa, that means that at some other point during the year, a treatment may shift, correct?
Exactly. Exactly.
That's exciting for your travelers because they get to try so many different things no matter when they come during the year.
Exactly. For example, if you come in the rainy season, because in the Andes, it's not like we have four defined seasons. It's basically two. We have a rainy season and a dry season. So in the rainy season is when we harvest corn, the giant white corn of the Andes. And it's a very milky and very fruity fresh corn when you harvest it. So for example, if we make exfoliations and hydrations of the skin of our guests at the spa in the rainy season, we use that. We use freshly mashed white corn kernels for those treatments. Whereas in the dry season, we use quinoa because quinoa is harvested in the dry season. So we use a combination of quinoa from our organic orchard combined with organic honey that comes from our neighbor. We have an apiculture right next door, and he provides us with this amazing organic honey that has all the scents and the tastes of the local terroir.
Oh, that sounds beautiful. I can kind of picture that creaminess of the corn and the moisture mm-hmm. and almost the bit of exfoliation, the quinoa and the honey. Wow. You mentioned a biogeodome?
A geodome.
Yeah, biogeodome. What is that? Mm-hmm.
We partner with a Brazilian company called Amerindia and their founder, Jorge. Jorge is a very accomplished architect who's one of the most prominent authorities in the construction of domes in South America. So he teaches at several universities and at several sustainable-oriented groups in South America how to build eco-friendly, sustainable structures based on a mathematical equation that allows you to calculate exactly how to use wooden frames to set up these large structures in a way they are anti-seismic, that in a way that use the least material possible with the least impact to the environment. So he came to our property to build our dome using locally sourced materials and using also local builders from our team. So they now have a new skill. Now they know how to build these kind of eco-friendly structures. And we use this dome for several experiences that we offer at the hotel, because Las Qolqas, when we were designing the philosophy of our property, we wanted it to become a haven in the midst of the Andes for exploration and self-discovery. So you have the opportunity to go out and venture into the wildlife and into the living culture of the Sacred Valley, but also you have time to reflect, to self-reflect, and to discover what your emotions and your learning experience can be in a spiritual journey within. So, and that's when we decided to build this dome as a place where you can meditate, you can do dance and movement, you can do yoga sessions, and you can also be part in rituals that we do in partnership with local healers.
Amazing. So when you're in this space, is it an open ceiling or structure? Is that how you're bringing nature in?
It is a wood and glass dome. The glass part faces east so that you can see sunrise. The rest is covered in a geothermal lining, which allows the place not to be too warm when it's sunny and hot outside, and for the structure not to be cold during the night. So it is a very peaceful and very, I forgot to mention, the acoustic in the place is amazing. I've had the pleasure of hosting guests who love singing, and you wouldn't believe how music sounds inside this structure.
Oh my gosh, that sounds absolutely beautiful. I imagine having a sound bath in there would be absolutely breathtaking.
Yeah, and when you are there, the surroundings, the mountains, they are so steep. The landscape is so dramatic. There is a condor's nest that is facing east. So on a clear day in the dry season, you can see the condors flying out of their nest and soaring above you. So it's quite a magical sight.
Oh, wow. I can't even believe that. And tell me, I noticed that you're doing tents for mm-hmm. your accommodations, but these are not your typical tents. It's not what you would ever think of when you think of a tent. So can you talk us through that?
Yeah, well, Herman wanted, he went to a trade show in Europe a few years ago. And when he passed by the African side of this show, he saw the luxury tented safari camps of the African outfitters. He thought it would be an impactless type of structure for our property, because our property used to be a cornfield when we acquired it. We wanted our impact to be as minimal as possible. So we adapted a tiny farmhouse to be the social areas of the hotel. That's where Our front desk, our bar are located, and also we attached a couple of terraces. We have a bar terrace, and then we have a greenhouse that is our restaurant. And the rooms we decided would be tents from the outside, but they are fully furnished hotel rooms in the inside with the special characteristic that they can be removable. If we decided to stop for whatever reason this project in the future, it only takes us 2 weeks to dismantle the whole property, and you can grow any vegetables in that soil again immediately, because our impact on the soil is non-existent. Just to give you an idea, the water that we use in the property, once it's being used in every area of the hotel, it goes through some piping towards biodigestors where the solids are separated from the liquids. We apply some special organic bacteria to these residues. And once the solid residues are free of pathogens, they can be compostable. So we take them to our organic orchard, and it's used as compost for our vegetables. And the liquids, once they have been cleared of all the pathogens, they go irrigate our native forest project that surrounds every room and every area of the hotel, because we have reintroduced the local forest into our property in an effort to bring in the ambient wildlife back again.
That is amazing. I've never heard of such advanced systems. And the fact that you're bringing this in a fantastic tourism space, so whoever stays there is actually contributing back to the economy, to the natural lands there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because we are very proud to say that not a single drop of either liquid or solid waste goes outside the hotel. It all gets reused, and in a positive way for the environment. And it shows, because it is amazing how we have mixed flocks of birds. We have lots of native hummingbirds. A couple of weeks ago, we spotted an Andean fox inside the property. So nature's coming back. When I see a mountain lion inside the property, I'll know for sure that we made it.
Oh my gosh. I don't want to be there when that happens. Did you know that turnover can cost a hospitality business 33% of the employee's salary? Not only that, but this industry has a 31% turnover rate. That's 3 times higher than recommended. Think about this when you're choosing your next salesperson. Shouldn't your funds go towards success? I know that every inch of your wellness resort was designed with thought and intention to serve the guest and contribute to their healing. It's beautiful. Well, let's design your sales and marketing team with the same tender, loving care. Throughout my career, I've met thousands of sales professionals. Even the most talented and successful struggle to properly sell wellness travel. Why is that? It's because they don't fully understand it. Inspire Journey Consulting offers wellness travel, sales, and marketing training that's curated to your property. With our support, your team can reach new levels of prosperity. Rather than continually pay for turnover, why not invest in retention? Let's talk more about it. Visit inspiredjourneyconsulting.com and go to the training page under the services menu. Or simply follow the link in the show notes. Schedule a discovery call today. Okay, so I need to know about the food. Can you talk us through some of your favorite dishes?
Yes, we don't have a menu. In order for us to serve something on the table at our Pututu restaurant, it has to be organic, it has to be locally sourced from the Cusco region, and it has to be in season. So every day, our chef, Linder, decides according to what's available from our local suppliers. He creates a 3-course meal for lunch and another one for dinner every day. But again, there are some things that our guests love and rave about. For example, our Andean trout ceviche. We have amazing pink trout coming from nearby streams The flavor of freshly caught trout is just delicious. Then we also have some amazing farmers who grow some of the most delicious Andean potatoes. They have, over the years, they have brought back the ancient pre-Columbian techniques to provide a potato. If you look at it, you think it is beetroot because it's so brightly dark red in color. Or there are these others that are of these very beautiful and deep violet color. And that is because they have such huge amount of antioxidants and protein in it and very low levels of starch. So these were the ancient potatoes that were really nourishing and replenishing of nutrients to the Andean population for millennia. Because we have vegan choices every day available to our guests. When we serve this huge array of Andean vegetables, which are superfoods, actually, because of the high levels of protein and amino acids and antioxidants that they have, we become a vegetarian haven.
That's amazing. I've never heard of a potato outside of a sweet potato, right? Being higher in protein and lower in starch. And that's a dream.
Absolutely. Absolutely. When you come and try it, and it will blow your mind.
I can't wait. So tell us a bit more about your journey. What brought you to this space?
I started developing sustainable initiatives 26 years ago, approximately. I think that my career in the travel industry is just the continuation of my upbringing, because my father was an army officer and my mother was a history and geography professor. And because of their careers, I traveled extensively all over the country, all over Peru, from a very early age. And my parents taught me to love and embrace diversity. They also told me to understand adversity, because our country is full of contradictions, as many other parts of the world are. You see a lot of poverty, but also you see the most hardworking and optimistic people facing difficult challenges in life through the history of violence that we had in our country because of terrorism from the late 70s until the early 2000s, actually. So it's been a long journey to leave this path of violence that overshadow the amazing things that our country has to offer. My parents taught me and my siblings to try to always do well for the rest. That the quality of living is not about what you get for you, but what you get for other people. It's been my journey to always develop sustainable businesses and opportunities for those who are in need of those opportunities to shine. And our people, the Peruvian people, they are so hardworking, they are so positive, so optimistic. Many times they don't have the opportunity to show that and to share it. And the Las Qolqas, to us, is the next best example of that, of how our team can shine. You see clients going to Linder, our chef, and hug him because they cannot believe all the things that he brings to table, or have a pisco punch at the bar with Charlie, with our bartender, who is teaching our guests how to make this local drink. And they just cherish those moments, going to the gardens with Santiago, with our gardener, and spending time with him, tending for the plants and trees. Those are the things that make a difference in a travel journey, but they also make a huge impact in our team, which is form of farmers, housewives, who were taught to provide this world-class quality experience to our guests. But at the same time, if they wouldn't have an opportunity to realize that they have those skills otherwise.
That means so much. When I think about the team receiving love in a way that they haven't been able to as frequently throughout their lives, what a gift to show people, this is what I do and this is how I care. and then get that incredible energy and feedback from travelers. And I think that's often forgotten, honestly, in the hospitality industry. So I really appreciate how the team at Las Qolqas enters this space differently.
Mm-hmm. Because of our sustainable approach, when we hire people, we don't only start by choosing people who live the nearest to the hotel in these farming villages nearby, but also we select and we give a priority to young people who are younger than 24 years of age, also women in our community and the elderly, people who are above 60 years of age. Those are the three groups that we favor when we hire, because those three groups, they have the least chances to be employed in our society. So most of the people in these three groups are underemployed or unemployed in Peru. And you wouldn't believe the high rate of single mothers in Peru. So I would say probably 60% of our team are women. And from all these beautiful, amazing, hardworking women, I would say 80% of them are single mothers.
Wow. Okay. I wish you were closer, Carlos, because I just want to give you a hug. This is such an amazing way to lift people up and to create equity.
Exactly. That's the idea, to get an equal opportunity for everyone. So to us, during the years of COVID, we couldn't hire elderly people, senior citizens, because of the COVID restrictions, of the health regulations. But now that we have 80% of our population fully vaccinated in Peru, we had a chance to do so. So we are slowly recruiting more senior citizens into our ranks, and they just love it. You wouldn't believe the person that comes in to our team, and after a couple of weeks, you see their eyes, you see their attitude. They are so vibrant and so radiant. It is something that really makes me feel happy and proud for this amazing team that we have.
Such a gift. And I do want to give credit and appreciation to how your parents raised you, because the idea of honoring diversity and also adversity is pretty fantastic.
Yeah, I think that's the biggest gift that I received from my parents, the chance to learn that the world is so different, so varied, and there can be hope even in the worst of the circumstances.
I would love to know, how has travel impacted your healing journey?
When I travel, my three favorite activities are to eat, to drink, both local, and to meet people. I think that through food and drink, you learn a lot about the nuances of a culture. And if you share it with the people of the places you visit, it's even more meaningful. So after 33 years that I've been in the travel industry already, the amount of amazing people that I've met all over the world, the possibility of going to a different country to get back in touch with people whom made an indelible mark in my spirit over the years. I've learned so much about people from all parts of life and how we can have a different cultural viewpoints, but at the same time have the same reactions to things that happen around us. And in a time when the world is so convulsed, we live in a world of two opposites at the moment. We have extremely conservative views that are fighting against extremely challenging and renewing views of the world at the moment. That's when the Andean mindset comes to help, because in the Andean cosmovision, which is very similar to other sacralized cultures in the world, especially in the East, opposites complement each other. So it is important to remember to have a balance, to have a clear spiritual path, that we have to embrace opposites in order to bring the best of both ends into a balance in the center. No matter what challenges we face as a human race, we have to remember that we have to take the best of it, and that we are just a tiny speck in the middle of the universe, and the universe will go on, regardless of what we do, regardless of what we say, regardless of what we think, regardless of what we feel. The universe will go on, and we will always be part of it. We came from the stars and will be eventually part of them in the future. So let's not take things too seriously and just love and give love.
I love that. I appreciate the Andean culture and towards honoring opposites, because honestly, it gives us the chance to learn. Mm-hmm. If we're around sameness, we don't grow.
Exactly. Exactly. Because of the things that we're doing at Las Qolqas, I was very honored to be nominated as the chairman of the newly formed Chamber of Commerce and Tourism of Ollantaytambo. And because of some political turmoil that we have everywhere in the world right now because of COVID and also the war in Ukraine and all that, I was also elected as the coordinator of all the 25 organizations of travel in the Cusco region recently. So I have to be involved in things that are so alien to me. Every single day I have a meeting with somebody from the Peruvian government or the regional government or a city hall of a particular city and things like that. It's a world that is so weird for me because I've never been into politics. But yesterday, for example, I had a meeting with this congressman who is from the most conservative party in Peru. So it's anti-abortion. This is a man who would never be a part of my social circle, for example, because I am on the opposite side of the spectrum. I'm pro-choice. I am pro-civil rights. But then sitting at the table with somebody who is on the opposite side and talking about how to develop laws for them to pass for the benefit of the travel industry in Peru, that is our common ground. From his own perspective, because I don't think that anyone does things just for pure evil or for pure goodness, we are just driven by objectives. And just sitting there with this man and developing these solutions, you can find from opposites a positive result for everyone. If you try to open your mind, if you try to open your heart and just find the goodness in the person in front of you.
I love that so much. And I think to myself, being in that situation, that room that you were in, probably mentally wanting to run the other way. But the diversity of thought that you brought into that room is going to yield a beautiful solution.
Yeah, because it's all about talking, listening. There is a lot to listen. And I think that's real empathy. It's so easy to empathize with things that go according to your values and principles, but it takes time, it takes restraint, patience, and a lot of listening to find common ground with somebody who seems so completely outside of your belief system. But that's the only way towards the future. There is no other way if we really want to come out of this bipolar world we are living in at the moment.
Absolutely. Carlos, you had mentioned when we previously spoke that Las Qolqas is one piece of what's going to be happening in this space in Cusco. Can you speak more to that?
There are many other entrepreneurs in Peru who are also strong believers in sustainability. We are starting with this tiny district of Ollantaytambo. In the near future, we want it to become a world-class sustainable destination for travelers by improving the quality of living of the citizens of this territory. And the idea is that by example, we engage the rest of the region of Cusco into this journey. And why not in some time, Peru can become a sustainable country. We have all the diversity, both natural and cultural. We have these amazing resources. And at the same time, we need to look at Mother Earth as that, as our mother, as a nurturer, and not just something material to exploit. And hopefully we will achieve that goal, if not in my lifetime, at least we may have planted the seed for the future generations to achieve that.
It's so magnificent and just sings to my soul, because you are really, this view that you take, it's not just in the property and how you see things and how you're working with community, but it's also building the lives and improving the lives of people living there, which will then create even more for tourism. Mm-hmm. It's phenomenal. You don't hear this often, so I hope you know that.
Thank you.
Extraordinary. Truly extraordinary.
Thank you. I consider myself a humanist. I'm always surprised about human nature, our contradictions, but also all the good and great that there is in humankind. But also my approach at everything tends to be holistic. So as amazing as human beings can be, we're just one of millions of entities in this universe. We have to remember that. We have to remember that we are just a tiny part of it. We have to respect other living forms, and we have to respect our surroundings, because they are just not for us to take. They are for us to share.
It's amazing, and a beautiful way for us to wrap up today. So, Carlos, tell us the best ways to either connect with you or learn more about Las Qolqas.
Well, both Las Qolqas and I, we are on Instagram. I think nowadays it's the easiest way to communicate. We also have a website, lasqolqas.com, a Qolqas both with Q. And well, hopefully I will get to see you in person soon. You will have a time to experience our beautiful surroundings in the Sacred Valley.
I would be honored. Well, thank you so much. I'm going to put all of those details in the show notes. And until next time, stay inspired.
Take care. So nice talking to you.
Thank you for joining Through Inspired Eyes. Don't forget to subscribe to this podcast and join the Travel Can Heal Challenge. Go to inspiredjourneyconsulting.com/travelcanheal to learn more. Until next time, stay inspired.